I'm drawing you numbers. People are going to want to hear me come on your show now because they had. Bro, don't you understand that we talk about you every single week? You were brought up on this show every single week because you're on the disco list. Okay, and we talk about you.
Nah, bro,
All of a sudden, Matt Cooner's on it. Like, oh my god, no, because people don't listen.
Bro, there's more to it than that. The last couple of weeks, it's really gone into like an ugly zone. And I know it's not me. Like it's not.
I noticed
me.
That.
You came out with a puppet of me, and you're just ignoring
that. That's comedy. Bro, that's not hatred. That's comedy, bro.
Okay, what's this guy's name? Joe. Is that what's his name?
Jay.
Yeah.
Jay, let me ask you a question. Wait one second. Jay, let me ask you a question. All right. You listen to the LBGQ show on Vince Russo, right?
Yes, I do.
Okay. And you listen to my show, right?
Yes. Yep.
Okay. I'm not asking you to take sides, but as a fan, what do you think here? Do you think Disco's being a dick? Do you think he's correct? Do you think he's just busting balls? What do you think?
We're by consistent.
Disco can definitely be a dick on the LGBTQ show. I got to be honest, bro. Oh,
everybody, shit. Conan, everybody That's says that. Everybody Vince, says, like, Vince, like, bro, I literally, Conan, I literally have people, I have people asking me, like, Vince, like, what did you do to this guy that he has such animosity towards you? And I'm like, bro, I'd love to know.
Vince, you got to remember, Disco's a professional dick, whether he's being one or giving a dick a hand job. Either one, him and Alex are always together. But
Vince, just don't worry about it. Don't let anybody know this, but I'm just trying to be as much of a heel as I can until the Wrestling Observer Awards come out and I win the best heel. I get best heel on the Wrestling Observer this year. So I have to heel on everybody until the voting. After the voting, if I don't get best heel, then everything's going to be back to normal.
Yeah.
Well, Vince, you know I got nothing but love for you, my brother. And so, you know, I want to thank you for taking this call and chopping it up with us.
And, this thing, too. Vince and Jeff are snowflakes. That's why this stuff upsets them on the show, 100%.
Wait a minute. What's going on, Vince?
Ibaka, is that accurate? Do you think Vince and Jeff act like snowflakes the way they react to me?
No, definitely not.
No. See, this is why the brand members are on my disco list, is because they're brainwashed by Vince and Jeff into conspiring against me to try to soil my bad, my good name. That's what they do.
The show South Park, right?
Which one?
South Park.
What about it? Yeah, of course, yeah.
You're like the Eric Cartman of Russo.
See that, Vince? You see?
I hear it from everybody every single week.
Yeah, because they are too. You have sensitive followers, snowflake followers. You try to say that, like, you guys are not marks and stuff. Then they react exactly like all the other wrestling fans.
It's got nothing to do with friendship.
He's got new friends. Have you seen his friends on Twitter that went to the Korean barbecue with him? Three fucking geeks, which he says they're not. You know, have you seen that?
No, I haven't seen.
That looked like a good time.
Attacking the people I went to go eat with in a despicable turn. You know.
Okay, when you get a chance, Vince, go to Twitter. Go to Glenn's thing. He went out to eat with three guys that are. One guy's a DJ. Okay, he definitely looks like he.
They're all DJs.
Let me tell you something.
One guy DJs in my strip club.
There's three guys. One guy looks 1,000% like he hung out with Jeffrey Epstein back in the day, 1,000% like child molester. And the other two guys look like they do fig bats, but they don't just give clean the fig. They get in the bathtub with it, and they all take a bath together.
Bathing suit on or off.
Yeah. Vince is laughing at that. While Conan is trying to say that I'm eating dinner with child molesters and people that play with boys.
Hey, Conan, you think that's funny? And you're saying
that I'm a bad friend. Okay,
Conan, I want you to know something. You literally popped my wife just now, and nothing wrestling related ever popped my wife. But you just popped my wife, Conan. Congratulations.
Well, show her the Twitter, she'll pop even more.
Yeah. But,
Vince, bro. Thank you very much for coming on the show. You know, I got nothing but love for you. And Thank you very much for taking the call, and you got to get me on your show.
You and me have mega heat. Bury me. 60 minutes, bury me. I'm not approving that.
Let me tell you why we have heat, Vince, because you invited me over 2 years ago to go over an ROE Speedwagon thing with you, and you have yet to bring me on the show to do that.
Huh. Bro, how do you remember that with all the pot you smoke, bro?
Conan.
How the hell do you remember that conversation?
Hey, Conan.
Yeah.
Yeah, Jay.
Conan, Vince did a vinyl review show with Mike Durbin. Does that have heat with you?
Oh, wait a minute.
1,000%. You need to get me on so we can review, because I know you're a big Beatles fan, right?
Oh, huge.
I'm a humongous Beatles fan. I don't subscribe to your theory that one of the guys is dead or alive or whatever. I think
it was Paul McCartney.
Yeah, I don't subscribe to that, but I am a big Beatles fan, REO Speedwagon fan. Are you a Journey fan?
Oh, big time, bro. Big time.
Journey fan, Led Zeppelin? Okay, Prince?
Yeah.
Okay, any of those, we can chop it up.
All right, bro. We'll do that. We got to get that done.
All right. Wow. Thank you very much, Vince, for being on Keeping It 100.
Boom. All right, man. Take care, man.
All right.
All right. See you, Vince. You better have the gloves on Thursday, Vince.
Yeah. All right. Okay. Bye.
All right. Cool.